Solid. So the answer is liquid, gas, solid. The answer is donkey. Okay, next. The molecular formula of sodium nitrate and magnesium chloride are NaNO3 and MgCl2 respectively. What is the molecular formula of magnesium nitrate? Okay, senang saja. Magnesium nitrate, ambil sajalah. Magnesium is Mg2+. Nitrate is NO3-. Then you cross, so it become MgNO3-2. So the answer is ball. Okay, next. Question 3. Elements are arranged in the modern predictable based on, okay, based on what? Respond. Based on what? Macam mana element in periodic table tu dia arrange? Dia susun based on? Respond. Proton number. Okay, very good. From left to right or from right to left atau daripada top to bottom? Bottom to top? Left to right, very good. Pandai. Pandai Puiman. Very good, Christy. Okay, now we go to question number 4. Diagram 2 shows a type of medicine used by a gastric patient. Sodium bicarbonate. Okay, sebelum kita pergi soalan ni, what is the formula for sodium bicarbonate? Siapa ada Google ke? What is the formula for sodium bicarbonate? Bicarbonate. Bukan sodium carbonate, sodium bicarbonate. What is the formula, guys? Apa formula sodium bicarbonate? Very good, Ganzing. Okay, sodium bicarbonate NaHCO3. So from the question, they ask you which of the following elements are present in the compound in diagram 2. So jawapan dia adalah C. Okay, sodium and carbon. Okay, next. Diagram 3 shows the setup the apparatus for electrolysis. Okay, of solution Y. Which of the following compounds could be used as solution Y? Kalau kamu tengok sini, the bulbs lights up. Mean the solution Y ni dia boleh conduct electric. So yang boleh conduct electric mestilah adalah ionic compound. And selain daripada tu dia mesti apa? Selain daripada ionic compound yang boleh conduct electric mesti juga dia adalah what? Other than ionic compound, dia juga mestilah very good, soluble. Okay, so based on the answer A, B, C, D, okay, propane cannot because propane is a covalent compound. Glucose also cannot. Okay, kita ada antara zinc sulfate dengan silver chloride. So these two both is ionic compound. Tapi yang mana tepat? Okay, betul Afika bagi. So antara C and D, which one is the best answer? Yang mana lagi, yang mana betul? Dua-dua ni adalah ionic compound. Tapi between C and D, yang mana yang jawapan yang paling betul? C, zinc sulfate, because zinc sulfate is soluble while silver chloride is insoluble. Okay, now we go to question 6. Diagram 4 below shows a model of the atom that was proposed by a scientist. Name the scientist who proposed the model. Okay, kalau kamu tengok dekat sini dia dah bagi tahu siap-siap. At the center it has nucleus that contain protons and neutron ataupun kita panggil sebagai nukleon. Okey, antara ramai-ramai ni, yang mana yang memperkenalkan this model? Ingat dulu cikgu pernah ajarkan di tangan. Okey, di tangan Robocop. Okey, Okey, D ni adalah Dalton. Tangan adalah Thompson. Row ni adalah Rutherford. B ni adalah Bohr dengan Cobb ni adalah Chadwick. Okey, itu dia punya nama ahlinya. Apa yang dia jumpa adalah anak emak. Anak emak pakai sangat nipis. Okey, anak dia jumpa atom. Okey, emak dia jumpa elektron. Pakai jumpa proton. S dia jumpa apa? Shell nipis dia jumpa neutron. Then kamu comparekanlah dengan sejarawan dekat atas ni. So Dalton dia jumpa atom, Thomson dia jumpa elektron, Rutherford jumpa proton, Bohr jumpa shell, and last one Chadwick dia jumpa neutron. Nah, dia lah yang last. So yang paling tepat jawapannya adalah Chadwick. Okay, sebab dia yang jumpa yang paling lengkap. So Chadwick. Okay, ini cara nak ingat. Kod lepas ni kamu susah kan nak ingat? Ini cara nak ingat dia. Very simple. Di tangan Robocop adalah nama saintis, and then anak emak pakai sangat nipis tu apa yang dia jumpa. Okay. Okay, next. Can we proceed to next question? Boleh ya? Okay, now we go to question 7. Okay, which of the following is diprotic acid? So you know what is diprotic acid? Respond please, what is diprotic acid? Apa itu diprotic acid? Diprotic acid is? Respond diprotic acid? Hello? Dalam ramai-ramai takkan seorang tak boleh respond what is diprotic acid? Ani Akmal, Afika Balkis. Tak apa lagi ni. Wei, Brian, what is diprotic acid? Okay, Sarah, very good. Diprotic acid means when acid ionize, it produce 2 mole of hydrogen ion. So diprotic acid yang biasa kita kenal, yang kita tahu adalah what examples of diprotic acid yang selalu kita jumpa? Sarah, what is diprotic acid? Give an example of diprotic acid. Sulfuric acid, very good. Very good, Puiman. Okay, very good, Sarah. H2SO4. Okay, completely ionized. It produce H plus and SO4. 2 minus, okay, and then we balance 2H plus. So ini yang menunjukkan this one is diprotic acid. When ionized, they produce 2 moles of hydrogen ion. Ya, yeah, Cewe? Okay, so yang paling betul adalah apa? Sini tak ada jawapan ni. Okay, formula for phosphoric acid. Apa dia phosphoric acid? What is the formula for phosphorus acid? Phosphorus acid? Okay, betul. Okay, cewek, diprotic acid means, okay, this one is the example of diprotic acid, H2SO4. When ionized in water, they produce 2 moles of hydrogen ion, like this. Nampak ni? Okay, ini nama dia diprotic. Boleh cuba? Ionized in water produce 2 moles of hydrogen ion. Okay, that one is diprotic acid. Okay, phosphorus acid is H3PO4. Okay, bila ionized dia akan jadi H plus campur PO4 3 minus. Okay, betul? And then look at here, this one 3, so we put 3 in front. So phosphorus acid is triprotic. Okay, carbonic acid, what is the formula of carbonic acid? Jumpa tak? Kalau kamu tak tahu formula, so masalahlah kamu nak kenal dia mono ke, di ke, tri ke. Carbonic acid formula. Carbonic acid. Respon. Carbonic acid. Brian, Alicia, Joel, Christy, Yoching, Heng Yap, respon, Yonggi. Okay, very good Joel. Pandai. Yes, betul. Lambat ke cikgu punya ni? Internet. Okay, betul. Pandai Rania. Pandai Joel. H3CO2. Okay, then this one. Kembali. H2CO3. Okay, ionize. H+CO3 2-. Okay. Ethanoic acid. Okay, dah biasa tahu CH3COOH. Okay, dia partially ionized CH3COO- plus H plus. And nitric acid is HNO3. Huh? Tak nampak? You all yang lain nampak tak? Oh, internet tak okey. Mungkin internet, sorry. Tak tahulah kenapa TM. Kemarah TM pula. Okay, H plus. Plus NO3 minus. So, from A, B, C, D yang diprotic adalah B. Because when ionize produce 2 moles of hydrogen ion. So, okay. Okay. Okay, ya. Yeah? Okay, now. Next. Alright. Sulfuric acid is produced in industry through contact process. Nah, kita dah belajar form 4, last chapter. What is the catalyst used? So, guys, what is catalyst? What is catalyst? Apa tu katalis? What is katalis? What is katalis? Apa itu katalis? Usna ada usna? Usna katalis tu apa? Usna ada ke sini? Tak ada usna ni. A substance that can lower activation energy. Okay. Sebenarnya catalyst is substance that increase the rate of reaction without changing itself chemically. Tu yang tepat, Sarah. Okay. Okay, so yang mana yang digunakan untuk contact process? Yang mana digunakan untuk contact process? Very good. Okay. Kamu kata C. Betul. Okay. Iron. Iron is catalyst used for what? Cikgu nak kamu nyatakan satu-satu. Iron is catalyst used for Haber. Pandai. Haber process. Haber process is process to produce what? Produce ammonia gas. Okay. How about platinum? Platinum catalyst used for platinum. Platinum. Platinum is catalyst used for what? Platinum is for Sarah. Shenshen, senyap je Shenshen. Yongji, platinum, platinum untuk apa? Para awni ada? Platinum is for what? Platinum is for hydrogenation. Very good, Yongji. Okay. Okay, hydrogenation ni kita guna untuk apa? Hydrogenation ni bila kita tambah hidrogen pada alkene, betul? Okay. Okay, how about manganese 4 oxide? Manganese 4 oxide is used as a... Manganese 4 oxide ni apa? Oxidizing agent. Okay, settle. Okay, so number 8C. And now we go to number 9. Which of the following is the structural formula for carboxylic acid? Okay, what is the general formula for carboxylic acid? General formula for carboxylic acid is CN. CN. What is the general formula for carboxylic acid? Okay, very good. So, okay, very good. Okay, so general formula is CN H2N plus 1 COO. Okay, so A, B, C, D adalah donkey. Okay, what is A? What is A? A is, ada double bond, so A is alkene. B, kat sini nampak ni. This one is ester. C, nampak dekat sini. Alcohol. Okay, next. Okay, what salt is soluble in water? Okay, cikgu dah banyak kali dah. Setiap kali masuk topik salt, cikgu akan bagi tahu how to memorize. Yang mana soluble, yang mana insoluble. Tak apa, ulang sekali lagi, banyak kali pun tak apa. We divide it into 4. And then we have nitrate. And then we have carbonate. We have sulfate. And we have chloride. Okay, again, all nitrate salt is soluble. Carbonate only SPA soluble. SPA stand for sodium, potassium and ammonium. Okay, sulfate all soluble except persatuan bahasa Cina. And chloride also all soluble except PUBG. Okay, lead dengan argentum. Lepas tu ada itu kamu cakap tambah apa mercury kan, Hg, satu agama Hindu. Okay, so antara banyak-banyak ni yang soluble adalah, okay, so C lah. The answer for question 10 is C. Okay, next. Next. Okay, question 11. Which of the following is endothermic reaction? Okay, endothermic reaction ni maksudnya temperature akan apa? What happened to the temperature? Temperature will increase ke decrease? Endo. Decrease, very good point. So, dia akan absorb heat. Okay, so antara A, B, C, D, agak-agak yang mana satu adalah endothermic? A, B, C, D. Zing, A, B, C, D. Okay, C, very good. Kalau kamu nampak A ni adalah acid dengan metal. B, metal displacement. D, neutralization. So kalau tengok kan A, B, D ni memang ketiga-tiga ni adalah exothermic reaction. So jawapan dia adalah C lah, decompositions of calcium carbonate. Okay. Okay, 12. What is the color of copper 2 carbonate powder? Ingat, all copper salt yang ada copper 2 plus is what color? Green. Green pula. Blue. Except Copper tu carbonate. Apa kalau copper tu carbonate? All copper ions, mana-mana salt yang ada copper ion is blue color except satu, that is copper tu carbonate. Apa kalau copper tu carbonate? Ani Akmal, green. Okay, betul. Okay, good. Okay, now we go to question 13. Diagram 5 shows a chemical cell. Chemical cell. Okay, chemical cell ni will convert what energy to what energy? Chemical cell ni akan convert energy apa to what energy? From what energy? Chemical cell. Respond. Weighing. Brian, mana Brian? Respond. Chemical cells, chemical energy to electric. Very good. Kalau chemical cell, dia akan convert chemical energy to electrical energy. Okay. So, kamu nampak sini dia guna dilute sulfur acid, dia guna magnesium rod. Which of the following represent X in order to give the highest voltmeter reading? Macam mana we want to produce highest voltmeter reading, Rania? How to produce highest voltmeter reading? Make sure what? How to produce highest voltmeter reading? Use metal low in ECS. Maksudnya make sure jawapan Brian tu lebih nice. Further distance in ECS between two meter. Lagi further, lagi higher voltmeter reading. Okay, so kita buatlah. Boleh Rania, cikgu faham apa yang kamu cakap. Betul. Tapi lagi betul jawapan Ryan lah. Okay. Okay, kita tulis ECS kalau nak kahwin mesti ada fleksibel supaya perkahwinan hasil cukup anak-anak. Okay, now dia bagi magnesium. Okay, so kalau magnesium dengan iron, dekat sini je. Okay, magnesium dengan zinc, oh lagi dekat. Magnesium dengan lead, bawah sikit. Magnesium dengan copper, paling jauh. So, yang paling produce highest voltmeter reading adalah copper. Okay, now we go to question 14. The following equation represent the oxidations of zinc atom. Okay, apa ciri-ciri oxidation reaction? Macam mana kamu nak tahu yang elemen itu atau substance itu teroxide? Pertama, kamu boleh tengok kalau daripada equation, kamu boleh tengok. Pertama, tengok apa? Tengok apa? Macam mana kita nak tahu either the reaction is oxidation ke reduction? Kita tengok apa? So, oxidation, okay, gain oksigen, satu, betul. Okay, lagi? Lagi? What happened to the oxidation number, Puiman? Oxidation number dia akan increase. Okay, number three, betul. Dia akan hilang hidrogen. Dan yang keempat, dia akan release electron. Very good, perfect. Semua betul yang tulis tu. Pandai, very good. Uiman, Saraf, Toh. Okay, so what is mean by oxidation based on the equation given? Okay, A. Electron are received by zinc ion. Salah. Electrons are donated by zinc ion. Salah. Electrons are received by zinc atom. Salah. Electrons are donated by zinc atom. Betul. So, 14, the answer is donkey. Okay, so yang cikgu tulis dekat sini ni, ini adalah oxidation. Kalau reduction, dia opposite lah dengan yang semua cikgu tulis ni. So, better you memorize one because another one just opposite saja. Okay, now we go to question 15. Alright, which pair is matched correctly? So, ini alloy. Okay, apa itu alloy? Apa itu alloy? What alloy, guys? Apa alloy? Siapa boleh state the definitions of alloy? Alloy, alloy. What is alloy? Auni ada, Auni? Para Auni, what is alloy? Melvin pun ada, apa itu alloy? Afika Bakis, alloy. Cepat, apa itu alloy? Combinations of two different metals. Okay, lagi? Betul, dah yang betul tu betul. Rania punya ayat tu betul, tapi ada sambungan dia lagi kan? Apa dia? Tolong sambung kawan-kawan. Apa dia alloy? Cuba selak-selak sikit buku apa tu alloy. Cuba selak sikit apa tu alloy. Presence of forest atom which of different size. Okay, mari kita tengok apa itu alloy. Okay, alloy is the mixture of two or more element. Okay, which a certain fixed composition and the major component in the mixture is a metal. Yeah, betul. Takut nanti kalau soal dia keluar soalan definition ke apa ke, sekurang-kurangnya kamu tahu kan. Eh, sekejap. Okay. Okay. So, now kita tengok alloy, brass, okay, copper. So, kalau hasilkan brass, dia mesti ada copper dengan apa? Major componentnya copper dengan what is the other component other than copper untuk brass? Selain daripada copper, dia mesti ada zinc. Pandai. So, copper plus. Copper plus zinc. Kejap. Okay, copper plus zinc. Okay, pewter. Pewter, apakah major component pewter? Adakah zinc? What is the major component of pewter? Tin. Okay, so ni salah lah. So major component dia tin. Bronze. Apakah major component untuk bronze? It's not tin. So apakah dia? Copper, betul. Copper campur apa? How to produce bronze? Copper campur? Okay, copper campur tin. Tapi bukan tin is the major component. And then, how to produce steel? Steel apa? Apa major component untuk steel? Iron, very good. So, jawapan yang tepat adalah A. Okay, now we go to question 16. When sodium thiosulfate solution react with acid, guess why with pungent smell produce. Okay, so apakah gas tersebut? Okay, so apakah gasnya adalah? Adakah sulfur? Sulfur bukan gas. Oksigen? Bukan. Oksigen dia bukan pungent smell. Okey, ada ke gas nama sodium dioxide? Tak ada. So kita tahu satu je gas, sulfur dioxide. Okey, so dia punya equation is Na2S2O3. Contohlah cikgu ambil HCl. So dia akan hasilkan garam. Okey, NaCl campur sulfur. Campur sulfur dioxide. Okay, next. Okay, 17. Diagram 6 shows the structural formula of two carbon. So, both is alkane. Dua-dua ni adalah alkane. Okay, apa nama A? What is the name for A? What is A? What is A? What is A, guys? Butane, okay. And B is pentin. Okey, pandai. Okey, antara A, B, C, D yang mana similar dari segi solubility? Kalau melting point yang mana ada higher melting point? A or B? Yang mana have higher melting point? A ke B? B. Kalau molar mass yang mana have higher molar mass? Of course lah. B. Kalau density pun B. So, alkane ni soluble ke insoluble? Ah, cepat jawab. Alkane soluble or insoluble? Okay, betul. Pandai. She know. Very good, Christy. Okay, so alkane is insoluble. Okay, now we go to question 18. Which pair is matched correctly? Okay, kita ada soap, kita ada deterjen. Okay, soap, dia punya general formula structural dia adalah R, C, double bond O, then dia ada O minus and A plus. Kalau deterjen, dia pun R juga. Longest carbon chain. Okay, dia ada O, tapi ingat dia ada S double bond O. Okay, and then Na plus. Beza between detergent and soap. Okay, kita tengok yang pertama. Contain acid, contain alkali. Macam tak betul. Okay, now kita pergi B. Soap made from vegetable oil, detergent made from petroleum. Okay, C, effective in hot water, detergent less effective in hot water. Ini memang dah nampak salah. Soap does not form scum in hot water, detergent form scum pun salah. So, yang paling betul adalah B. Okay, B. Okay, 19. Elemen P and Q are located in group 2. Okay, tulis P group 2 and then Q group 17. Okay, so dia punya apa? Electron orange, electron valence 7 ni electron valence dia 2. What is the chemical formula? Senang saja, PQ2. So jawapannya ball. Okay, question 20. Which reaction produce the lowest heat of neutralization? Okay, yang mana akan produce lowest heat of neutralization? Teka, agak-agak apa jawapan dia? A, B, C, D. Chino, 20. Which one is the best answer? C? Ya ke D? Lagi A, B. Okay, the best answer is A. Kenapa A? Eh, sorry. Donkey. Kenapa donkey? Kenapa donkey? Oh, pandai pun main. Because donkey ni, this one is weak acid, this one weak alkali. Kalau A, dua-dua strong. Kalau B, this one weak, this one strong. Kalau C, strong, weak. Donkey, both weak. So, dia akan produce less heat of neutralization. Okay, which of the following substance consists of atom? Atom ni maksudnya dia single lah. Okay. Water tak? Water H2O. Water H2O ni apa? Kira apa? H2O kira? Right. Ya ke molekul? Ya ke ion? H2O, water. Molekul. Oksigen, gas. Molekul. Helium, He. Naphthalene, molekul. So jawapan ni adalah helium. 21 C. Apa formula naphthalene ingat tak? Ingat tak formula naphthalene? Tak ingat. Formula naphthalene, siapa-siapa ingat? Okay, now we go to question 22. Diagram 7 below shows the arrangement of electrons in atom G. Okay, dia bagi gambar aja. Kita kira betul-betul berapakah electron arrangement? 2.1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8.3. So, kita tahu dah daripada 2.8.3 we know atom G in group 13 period 3. Okay. So, which statement is correct? Place in period 3, ya yeah, betul. Place in group 13, ya yeah, betul. The ion of G is G3 minus. Salah. Sepatutnya dia akan jadi G3 plus. Sebab dia group 13, group 13 dia adalah metal, dia akan release elektron. Okay, G form an ionic compound with formula G3O2 when react with oxygen. Betul ke salah? G form an ionic compound with formula when react with oxygen. Betul tak? Salah, sepatutnya ni akan jadi G2O3, bukan G3O2. So, jawapan yang tepat adalah A. 1 and 2 only. Good. Okay, question 23. Element L react with element M to form an ionic compound with the formula LM2. Okay. The electron arrangement of M is 2.8.7. Which of the following is possible electron arrangement of L? Okay, kalau LM2 kita tahulah L mesti L2 plus. M mesti M minus kan? Sebab sini M is 2.8.7. So dia akan receive one electron. So L2 plus mestilah group. Group berapa ni? Group 2. So jawapannya ball. Okay, 23 ball. Ada masalah dengan soalan 23? I think okay. Tak ada lagi setakat ni jumpa soalan yang agak-agak mencabar ke, yang pusing-pusing ke. Semua macam straight to the point soalan ni. Okay, soalan 24. Which statement shows the difference between hexene? Okay, double bond dengan hexane, single bond. Okay, apa beza dia? Hexane dissolve in water but hexane does not. Okay, the carbon percentage per molecule of hexane is higher. Okay, carbon percentage ni kalau tak confident kamu kira sahaja. Tahu tak kira macam mana kira carbon percentage? Pandai tak kira carbon percentage? Contohlah kalau hexane. Hexane formula dia berapa? Hexane C6H12. Hexane C6H14. Okay. So kamu kira lah carbon percent. Cikgu kira lah untuk hexane dia macam ni. Kalau ada carbon ada 6, 6 times the molar mass 12 divide by total 6 times 12 plus 12 times 100. Dapatlah berapa persen. Okay. The number of hydrogen atoms per molecule of hexane is higher. Salah. Kalau tengok situ hexane lagi banyak. Hexane decolorize the brown color of brown water but hexane does not. Salah. Terbalik. Should be hexane yang decolorize the brown of bromine water. So jawapan paling tepat adalah ball. Okay. Okay, 25. Boleh ya? Okay, now we go soalan 25. The joint of a student's leg is swollen and painful. What medicine is suitable to given to the student? Ah, sini ada tulis painful. So, kamu sebagai seorang doktor, apakah yang paling sesuai untuk bagi mereka? A, B, C, D. Okay, very good. Zing Yul, bagus Saraf. Pandai Melvin. Insulin ni untuk apa? Ah, doktor-doktor pakar sekalian, insulin is for what? Insulin is for what? Okay, jika seseorang tu mengalami diabetic, glucose level dia tinggi. Okay, penicillin ni adalah one type of what? Penicillin. Penicillin ni sejenis ubat apa ni? Penicillin. Antibiotik. Very good. Okay. Okay, barbiturat. Barbiturat untuk apa? Barbiturat, Marilyn, Roy, barbiturat. Depressed. Okay, very good, Melvin. Okay, one more is paracetamol. Okay, paracetamol ni kalau soalan kadang-kadang dia akan tanya partner dia. Siapa partner paracetamol? Selalu diorang minta you all compare. Paracetamol and what? Satu lagi apa? Paracetamol, kalau kawan dia apa satu lagi? Yang selalu orang akan akan soalan akan tanya. Aspirin, very good. Mana yang better, paracetamol or aspirin? Okay, dia selalu akan tanya. Yang mana more suitable for kids? Ha, dia akan tanya soalan macam tu. And then why? Kamu jawablah. Dah belajar kan? Okay, setakat soalan 25. Ada masalah? Any question guys? So, until 25? Kalau ada masalah, bagi tahu. Until question 25 ada masalah? Takut kamu ni tertinggal ke apa ke, ada soalan nak tanya until question 25. Okay. Everyone got full mark 25 over 25 ke 24 over 25? Very good kalau dapat 25 over 25, 24 over 25, at least kamu salah 1, 2. Kita kalau boleh untuk paper 1 ni, kalau betul-betul nak, kalau kamu bercita-cita betul nak dapat A+, kamu kena salah maksimum 5 sahaja untuk kertas 1. Okay. Kalau bercita-cita dan bersungguh-sungguh nak dapat A+, paper 1 mesti dapat 45 above. Baru kuat. Okay, question 26. Okay, this one is tyre. Which statement is true about substance X? Okay, kalau kamu tengoklah tayar kereta ni selalunya jenis rubber apa ni? Rubber ada dua kan, vulcanized and unvulcanized. So agak-agak kalau untuk make tyre ni using what type of rubber? Vulcanized ke unvulcanized? Vulcanized ke unvulcanized? Vulcanized, pandai. Okay, vulcanized rubber. Okay, okay. Now, substance X less resistant to oxidation. Betul? Salah. Substance X has low melting point. Salah. Substance X is more elastic due to the presence of carbon crosslink. Betul ke salah C ni? Christy? Salah ke betul? Ya ke? Tengok dia kata carbon crosslink. Sepatutnya apa yang crosslink? Carbon crosslink sulfur. Ha, pandai pun. Hati-hati, dia saja perangkap kamu. Substance X is produced by soaking rubber in a solution of sulfur monochloride in methyl benzene. So, jawapan paling tepat adalah donkey. Tengok, memang nampak crosslink tapi carbon sebenarnya dia adalah sulfur crosslink. Ha, ni betul lah. Memang Christy dalam buku pun memang bagi tahu dah ada dah untuk vulcanized rubber dia akan sokkan dalam sulfur monochloride in methyl benzene. Ya, betul. Okay, 27. The chemical equation below shows the reaction between iron trioxide and carbon. The oxidation number of iron reaction change from senang saja kita tengok Fe kat sini berapa charge dia ni? Because the charge of iron sama dengan dia punya oxidation number. So this one is Fe. 2 plus ke 3 plus guys? Fe kat sini Fe 3 plus ke Fe 2 plus? Fe ya ke 2 plus? Fe 3 plus. So after reaction dia jadi 0. Okay, so plus 3 to 0. Jawapannya boy. Okay, now question 28. Okay, cool pack. Cool pack ni dia pakai reaction apa? This cool pack using what reaction? Endo ke EXO? Cool pack. Endo, okay. Which statement explain the reaction occur in a cool pack? Okay. This reaction release heat. Betul kah? Release heat? Salah. Delta H has negative value. No. The total energy content of the reactant is lower than the product. Okay, tengok betul. Cikgu lukis sikit dia punya energy level diagram. Okay, kalau endothermic maksudnya dia akan naik. So, ni reactant dia akan naik. So, ni arrow. Aduh, arrow. Ni straight. Product. So, dia kata total energy content of reactant lower than the product. Okay, nampaknya macam betul. Examples of reaction when solid NaO is dissolved in water. Salah. Okay, so jawapan paling tepat adalah C. Okay, next. Okay, now we go to question 29. The following chemical equation represent the reaction between zinc and HCl. Which changes can be used to determine the ROR? Mass of zinc per unit time. Boleh tak? Boleh. Color of solution. Ada perubahan warna ke? What is the color for zinc chloride? Apa warna zinc chloride, guys? Guys? Balkis? Balkis? Dua-dua balkis? Apa nama, apa warna for zinc chloride? Brown? Ya, betul, Christy. Dia bukan white. Color apa? Ya ke white? Colorless. White and okay, cikgu nak bagi tahu ya. White and colorless lain. White is white lah. This one white. Kalau colorless mean dia transparent. Okay. Jangan confuse between white and colorless. Colorless is transparent. Macam warna, macam air. Ah kan. Kalau white, ni warna putih ni white. Okay, so nombor dua bukan. Okay, volume of hydrogen gas released per unit time. Betul. Mass of zinc chloride produced per time. Betul ke tak nombor empat ni? Mass of zinc chloride produced. Boleh terima ke tak? Weighing? Tak. Kenapa saraf tak? Sebab zinc chloride is, nampak ni dia tulis aqueous solution. Dia adalah soluble. So jawapannya ball 1 and 3. Okey, kita pergi ke soalan 30. Oh, baru 30. Okey, soalan ke 30. Diagram then shows the electrolysis of silver nitrate, okey, using silver as electrode. Okey, silver nitrate. Okey, silver electrode. Which of the following half equation represent the reaction at anode and cathode? So nak tahu mana anode? Anode yang panjang ni anode. Ni cathode. So kalau kat anode mesti mesti apa? Kat anode mesti apa? Cikgu dah banyak kali pesan. Anode mesti release while cathode dia akan receive. Okay, so what happen here? Here is Ag. Ag. Ag electrode ni dia akan release electron become Ag plus plus E. So at here what happen? Ag ion yang ada dalam ni akan Ag ion inside the silver nitrate solution will receive electron become Ag. Right? So silver electrode at anode become thinner and silver silver akan dekat sini akan apa, akan terkumpul dekat silver electrode sini, okay, deposited. So jawapannya adalah mana? Kenapa cikgu tak pilih H? Okay, kalau dalam silver nitrate solution ni dia ada Ag, dia ada nitrate, dia ada H plus dengan OH minus. Kenapa cikgu tak pilih H? Kenapa cikgu pilih Ag? Tahu tak kenapa? Pandai pun Man. Ag lower than hydrogen in HCl. So jawapannya adalah ball. Okay, what is the oxidation number of Y in YO42 minus? Pandai tak kira? Okay, then ini nama dia complex ion. So bila ada complex ion macam ni, so Y tak tahu. Okay, oksigen dia punya oxidation number is negative 2 times ada berapa oksigen? Ada 4 equals to ambil ni. Oxidation number total dia is negative 2. So Y minus 8 equals to negative 2. So Y equals to plus 6. Jawapannya adalah C. Okay, 32. Okay, Sean immersed a piece of filter paper in a beaker containing solution X. Then he used solution Y. Okay, ada X, ada Y. To write I love chemistry on the filter paper after the filter paper was dry. The wording on the filter paper is yellow in color. Okay. Agak-agak kalau yellow tu mesti ada apa? Kamu tengok sini ya. Kalau kalau dia kata ada yellow in color, maksudnya dekat sini ada yang insoluble salt. Betul tak? Betul tak? Sebab dia ada has tinggalkan kesan kan? Okay, dia maksudnya dia akan hasilkan one yang insoluble. So, kita tengok satu-satu sini. Sodium iodide dengan silver nitrate. So, bila kita reactkan dia, dia akan jadi apa ni? Sodium nitrate kawan dengan argentum iodide. Okay, kalau ni sodium iodide dengan lead to nitrate, dia akan jadi sodium nitrate campur dengan lead to iodide. Okay. Alright, kalau barium chloride dengan sodium nitrate, dia akan jadi barium nitrate kawin dengan kawin pula plus dengan sodium chloride. Okay, kalau ini dia akan jadi barium nitrate dengan copper chloride. Okay, so yang mana satu? Okay, kalau ikutkan ini dua-dua soluble, dua-dua soluble. Bukan. Okay, ni soluble, 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 soluble. Kena kita tengok A dengan B. Soluble, yang ni kita pun kita tak pastikan. Tapi dia kata sini yellow. Selalunya kalau yellow, yang mana satu warna yellow? Contohlah kamu tak tahu kan AGI ke PBI tu, sebab yang ni soluble kan. Agak-agak yang mana warna yellow? AGI ke PBI tu? Yes, pandai tu B. Okay, so 32 B. Okay, nah 33. Okay, dia bagi kamu shell dengan ethanoic acid. So agak-agak gas apa yang release tu bila shell dengan acid? Shell ni apa? Chemical formula untuk shell. Shell ada apa? Dalam shell ada apa? Kalsium karbonat. So bila kalsium karbonat pandai react dengan ethanoic acid, gas release is apakah gas release? Carbon dioxide. Okay, next. Kumpat dah. Diagram 12 shows the electron arrangement of X and Y. Which of the following is true about the reaction? Okay, kita tengok X ni is 2.8.1. Ini 2.8.7. Senang saja. Atom X donate 2 electron. Salah. Okay. Atom Y receive 1 electron. Ya, betul. An ionic compound is formed. Ya, betul. The compound form has chemical formula XY2. Salah. So the answer is 2 and 3. Okay, 35. Caffeine is a natural stimulant found in coffee, tea and cocoa bean. What is the percentage of carbon atom by mass this compound? Okay, so how to calculate the percentage of carbon. Senang saja cikgu dah ajar yang tadi kan. Kamu ambil carbon dulu sebab dia minta kamu cari percent of carbon kan. So 8 times the molar mass of carbon 12. And then divide by 8 times 12 plus 10 hydrogen and then 4 nitrogen 14 plus 4 plus 16 times 2 for oxygen and then time 100. Tekan calculator, apa jawapan dia guys? 35, jawapannya apa? 35. Okay, 35 jawapan dia. C, okay. Cikgu sambung lagi eh, kita habiskanlah halang-halang. Okay, 36. The diagram shows the element W, X, Y and Z are not the actual symbols of the element. Okay, which of the following shows the correct arrangement of element blah 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 in order of increasing atom? Okay, cikgu nak pesan. Yang pertama, when down the group size, when down the group size, increase. Okay, when down the group size, increase. And then one more from right to left, size, increase. Okay. From right to left, size increase. Down the group, size increase. So, they increasing atomic size mestilah Z, Y, W and X. So, jawapannya adalah ball. Z, Y, W, X. So, tip dia senang saja. Down the group, size increase. Right to left, size increase. Okay, 37. Food additive, which of the following can be used to make the flavoring? Kalau kamu tengok ini adalah structure of ester. So ester mesti ada carboxylic acid. That one is here. And then this one is alcohol. So apa nama carboxylic acid kat sini? Tengok ada how many C? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this one is pentanoic acid. 5 kan? Kira sekali ya C ni jangan lupa and then this two is for alcohol, ethanol. So adalah antara pentanoic acid dengan ethanol. So jawapannya A. Okay next, we go to question 38. Okay, the reaction between excess marble of 50 cm3 of 2 mol hydrochloric acid produce of carbon dioxide. Okay, in experiment, if the experiment repeated using which solution will produce curve in 2? Okay. Okay, maksudnya 2 ni dia less steeper. Okay, less steeper. Less steeper. Okay, less steeper. Okay, apa faktor yang mempengaruhi ROR? Kita dah belajar faktor-faktor yang mempengaruhi kestiperan sesuatu graf tu adalah pertama, kita tengok dari segi what? What is the factor that affect the ROR? First, apa faktor? Okay, temperature lagi. Catalyst, betul? Okay, ketiga, concentration. Keempat adalah size. Very good. Okay, now kita tengok yang mana yang paling sesuai. Okay, 50 cm3, 1 mol HCl. Okay. 1 mol. Okay, ini pun concentration dia berubah. 1 mol of HCl. Okay. Okay, kedua. 1 mol of sulfuric acid. Okay, dia guna sulfuric acid. Okay, yang ni dia pakai 25 cm3. Yang berubahnya volume. So, bukan. Ini bukan. 25 cm3 sulfuric acid. Okay, pun bukan. So, the best answer is A. Jawapannya A. Okay. And now we go to question 39. Okay, a substance which melts at 105. Melt tu maksudnya daripada solid tu liquid and boil, boil adalah liquid tu gas. Okay, which of the following graph temperature against time for heating? A, B, C. Ingat dia bagi tahu kat atas ni. Heated from room temperature to 300. Ah, maksudnya betul-betul lah ni. Betul-betul sampai habis. Lebih daripada boiling point. So jawapan paling sesuai adalah ABCD, cepat. Kalau kamu tengok graf ABCD, A memang taklah, B pun tidak. Sebab dia kata dia mula dengan room temperature. C pun tak. Jawapannya adalah donkey. So kita assume lah ini adalah 300. Okay, 40. Okay, 10 lagi. Okay, a decorative glassware makes encounter problem on his product which are fragile. He need another material which is transparent. Dia nak yang sama, transparent tapi tak fragile. To replace glass. What is the most suitable? So, yang mana sesuai? Yang mana sesuai? So yang mana sesuai? Okay, polyethylene. Polyethylene ni apa? Polyethylene sesuai guna untuk apa? Polyethylene sesuai untuk apa? Plastik. Okay, plastik bag. Container. Polypropane buat bottle cap. Okay. Boleh guna untuk buat apa lagi ni? Tote bag. Okay. Polychloroethane ni ini adalah PVC. And jawapan yang sebenar adalah donkey. Polymethyl metachloride. Ini digunakan untuk buat safety glass. Tahu tak safety glass? Pernah pakai tak dekat lab? Cikgu rasa cikgu pernah bagi you all pakai safety glass tu. Boleh juga buat untuk car lamp. Okay, next. The following chemical equation shows decompositions of hydrogen peroxide. Calculate the volume of oxygen produced from the decompositions of hydrogen. So, macam mana nak buat ni? Jadi kita nak buat, pertama apa kita kena buat? Dia dah bagi mass of hydrogen peroxide. So first step kita cari mole of hydrogen peroxide. So 30.3 divide by 34. So mole dia berapa? 0.8912 mole. Okay, second step, ratio antara H2O2 dengan dia minta cari oksigen dengan oksigen. From equation this one 2, this one 1. So if this one is 0.8912, this one should be 0.4456 mole. Okay, dah dapat dah dekat sini. Okay, next. And then barulah kita cari volume. 0.4456 times, sini dah bagi 24, and then tekan kalkulator. Okay, apakah jawapan anda? Apa jawapan? A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D. A, very good. Yang lain senyap ke 32 orang? Ui, main zarah je jawab ni. Okay, 42. Which of following arrangement of metal XY and Z in descending order. Okay, kita tengok dulu. Kita mulakan dengan yang paling besar dia punya bacaan voltage. Y and Z. Di mana Z is negative terminal means Z dekat atas. Okay, Y dekat bawah. Okay, ini bacaan dia 1.15. Okay, next. Kita ambil yang Q, X dengan Z. Okay, Z ke atas. Okay, Q. Okay, di sini bacaan dia 0.65. And then X dengan Y. Okay, X dengan Y. Okay, X mungkin dekat sini. Alright. So, sini 0.5. Okay, so susunan dia adalah descending order menurun daripada yang tinggi Z. Mana? Kenapa tiba-tiba ada Q pula ni? Salah ni. Tak ada Q ni. Z dengan X. So Z, X, Y. Okay, jawapannya A. Alright. Okay, now we go to the next question. Okay, in the titration, the initial burette reading is 5 cm³. Okay, initial dia 5 cm³. Okay, initial 5 cm³. Final 30. Agak-agak berapa yang dia guna? Dia guna adalah 25 cm³. Okay, 25 cm³. Okay, the color change from pink to colorless at the end point. Betul ke? Betul? Betul tak daripada pink to colorless? Betul ke tidak? Betul. Sebab masa bila ada alkali dia pink. Bila dia dah sampai end point, means dia neutral, dia akan jadi colorless. Okay, the volume of sulfuric acid used is 30. Salah, 25. The concentration used is 0.5. Salah. And then the product at the end point are potassium sulfate and water. Betul kan? Sebab kita guna potassium hydroxide react dengan sulfuric acid. So potassium sulfate and water. So jawapannya is 1 and 4A. Okay, next we go to 4-4. What is the average rate of reaction in second minute? Minit kedua. Bukan in 2 minute, in second minute. So kita kena tengok antara ini second minute dengan first minute. So caranya adalah tolak first minute bahagi dengan masa lah. So second minute is 36 minus 24. Masa pun tukarlah daripada, sebab dalam saat kan. Okay, dia daripada 120 tolak 60. Sebab ini minit yang kedua, ini yang pertama. So kita nak yang minit kedua saja. So jawapannya adalah 0.2. Jawapannya donkey. 36 minus 24, 120 minus 60. So jawapannya donkey. Okay, 45. Okay, shows a type of food that is used as flavoring. So jawapannya apa ni untuk tomato ketchup? Kalau ikutkan untuk tomato ketchup ini, untuk dipanaskan dengan kuat. Okay, tomato ketchup apa? Yang paling tepat sekali adalah A, B, C, D. Okay, betul pun maksud dia. Nitrate, pandai. Very good. Okay, hampir habis. Okay, 46. Determine the heat of precipitate. Okay, tengok dia bagi kamu initial temperature, initial temperature. So initial temperature untuk dua-dua ni is 20. Okay, 32. Calculate a heat of precipitate. Formula dia is delta H equals to MC theta divided by X. Okay, M berapa? M kita kena campur kedua-dua volume. So 25 campur 25. Okay, 4.2 memang dah bagi. Okay, theta tadi 32 minus 28. Okay, how to find X? Okay, macam mana kita nak kira mol? Kita ambillah satu, salah satu daripada atas ni, kita guna formula MV over 1000. And then kita masukkanlah, substitutekan dia. Okay, MV over 1000, kita ambil sini, this one is 20, 0.5, this one is 25, and then divide by 1000. So dapat 0.0125. Masukkan kat sini 0.0125. Tekan calculator. Kenapa boleh pilih mana-mana? Sebab kalau kita buat dia punya chemical equation pun semua dah balance 111. So tak ada masalah. Okay, so tekan-tekan calculator. So the answer is ball. Okay, now we go to next. Okay, very good. 47. Okay, glacial ethanoic acid. What is glacial, guys? Glacial ni maksudnya dia adalah pure acid. So the bulk does not line up when using glacial ethanoic acid. So what should we do? We pour ethanol into glacial ethanoic. Salah. Pour water into glacial. Yeah, because when we pour water in glacial, dia akan ionize, dia akan produce ion. Replace carbon bukan, replace glacial pun bukan. Okay, B. Okay, 48. A, B, C. What is the total percentage of nitrogen in the chosen fertilizer? Dia minta kamu choose the fertilizer with highest nitrogen. So jawapan dia Okey, jawapan. Jawapannya? Sekejap eh. Hello. Ya. Ya saya. Haah. Lepas tu melecek lagi. Haah. Sudah. Lepas tu? Tapi dia nangis tak? Oh, ni tak ada. Oh. Takut patah eh. Oh, bang, okey lah. Oh, okey. Okey, tak apa. Tak apa, nanti saya cek. Oh, takut dia bengkak ke apa eh. Oh, baru ke kena? Oh, biar dulu. Oh, okey, tak apa. Nanti saya datang. Saya pun nak gerak dah ni, okey? Okey, kasih. Sorry. okey, sambung sikit lagi. Kejap, kita sambung. Sekejap eh. Okey, alright. Okey, cikgu sambunglah. Allahuakbar. Okey, 48. Okey, 48. Jawapan dia. Okey, 48 jawapannya adalah B. Okay, 48, jawapannya B. Alright, 49. Okay, cikgu bagi jawapan duration. Okay, duration between excessing and hydrochloric acid produce 20 cm3 of hydrogen in 10 seconds. Complete in 1 minute and the maximum volume of hydrogen obtained is 40. What is the average rate at 10 seconds? Oh, so kita fokus dekat 10 seconds je lah. 10 seconds dia boleh kumpul 20 cm3. Okay, divide by 10 second. So the answer is C. Okay, 49C. And last one. Okay, apparatus. Okay, this one redox. Ni sebenarnya kalau tengok ni bukan iron 2 ni cikgu rasa. Jawapan dia sini adalah iron 3. Okay. So dia tanya which of the following reaction occur in the solution. First you must identify yang mana oxidizing agent, yang mana reducing agent. Okay, so kalau ikutkan potassium iodide adalah oxidizing agent, okey. Potassium adalah oxidizing agent. Salah, minta maaf. Iron 3 is oxidizing agent. Okey, so kalau oxidizing agent ni dia ada mengalami reduction. So the movement of ion daripada right to left. Okay, so what happen? Iodide ion is oxidized to iodine molecules. Iron 3 oxidized to iron 2. Okay, jawapannya adalah A. Alright, that's all. Okay, we stop here. Okay, cikgu nak pergi ambil anak kejap. Okay, ya. Okay, bye. Salah soalan tu 50 tu. Patutnya iron 3. Okay. Okay, bye.